Welcome to Department of Electronics and Telecommunication at Vidya Alankar Institute of Technology. In this department, we have taken this new initiative to start our own YouTube channel. In this YouTube channel, we are going to upload all our experiments video, value-added course video, or any other important videos. This material will be available to all the students in Mumbai University, and this material will help students to enhance their learning, not just in their classroom, but even outside the classroom. I hope that everyone will like this our effort, and in case of any query, comments, anything, they can put it in comment box. Thank you.
Welcome to Communication Engineering Lab. Today we are going to discuss about Yagyoda antenna, and we'll plot the characteristics of Yagyoda antenna. So this is the setup of Yagyoda antenna. As you can see, this is the Yagyoda antenna, which is acting as a transmitter. These three dipoles are reflectors. So this is the Yagyoda antenna. These three elements are the detector elements, and this is the reflector element, and this element is called driver element. The reflector element is always the longest one. Similar to dipole antenna, the receiver is placed as if it gets the maximum deflection when the transmitting antenna, which is the Yagyoda antenna, is placed at 0 degree incidence. So similar to dipole antenna, the transmitting antenna is set at 0, and the receiving antenna, which is shown by the milliammeter, is set at the maximum value, which is beyond 50. So in order to note down the readings, we'll rotate the antenna by 30 degree. So there 30. As we can see, at the milliammeter, the reading is getting reduced more 30 degree. So it is reduced again. Similarly, we'll note down after every 30 intervals, and we'll plot the graph.
So these are the observed value that we have observed after rotating the incident angle from 0 degree to 360 degree. The right hand side column shows us the reading in microammeter, which was placed at the receiver. As you can see, we have two values at the start and two values at the end. So now, considering this observed value, we are going to draw the graph. So as we can see, the radiation pattern is towards only one side, which is the right hand side. Since it is a Yagyoda antenna, it is highly directional, so we are getting a direction only in one side. So that's it for the Yagyoda antenna. Thanks for watching.